Hi, I'm Seth Freudberg. I'm the director of options trading here at SMBU in Manhattan, and I'm also the head trader of SMB's options trading desk. Today, I'd like to field a question which has come in to SMB about options trading. Mike Bellafiore, who is one of the founding partners of SMB, one of its principals, he's got on Yahoo Finance a column, blog that he writes called The Trading Coach. And he invites readers to ask trading questions, and he takes a shot at answering them. Mike referred this one over to me, and we thought we'd turn it into a video for everybody. I run our options trading desk, and I also run our options tribe, which is our online community of options traders. And the big advantage of the options tribe and our options trading desk is that we get the opportunity to bounce ideas off of the principals here at SMB who have been trading the markets for decades, Mike Bellafiore and Steve Spencer in particular. They help us to not only come up with trading ideas and approaches to the market, but also how to train traders, which is really our passion here at SMB, how to train people to become elite traders. SMB, long before the options tribe ever existed, long before we ever created our options foundation program, established what I consider, and I've taken it myself, so I should know, the best equity training, intraday equity day trading program out there in the market. It can't be beat. The amount of information that's given to traders is spectacular. And so we get, these are guys who built a trading desk from the ground up, trained traders from the ground up. And now, as we're developing our options business, they are assisting me greatly in the process of training traders. Not just people who end up on our trading desk, which is the ultimate goal, but folks who maybe have their own capital and have enough capital to trade and make a living on their own. They're getting the same benefit of talking to Mike and Steve and the other great experienced traders around here. So the idea is they help to assure that we've got the highest quality education out there in the option space, just as we do in the equity space. Now, the question that came in today might be a little elementary to those of you who are experienced options traders, in which case, good for you. It means you're an advanced person with advanced knowledge in options trading, and I think that's terrific. But the options tribe is a one-room schoolhouse, and we have people who literally know nothing about options and people who could write books about options, and they all attend, and that's what's great. People learn from each other, and sometimes reviewing a concept you thought you understood, if you get a review of it, a refresher course, perhaps there's something that comes out that you didn't really think of before, and it deepens your understanding of what you thought was otherwise an elementary concept. So here goes a real, real simple question from a sincere trader who is interested in options trading, and here's how it goes. Hi, Coach. I'm new at options and wanted to start option trading, but I'm very confused about calls and puts. So I've got some questions that my friend gave me in order for me to understand options trading. So here are the questions. What does it mean to buy an Apple 123 call expiring August 7th? Today's the 5th, so it's a couple days from now. What does that mean? A call is a right to buy 100 shares of a stock at a certain price. In this case, the price would be 123. Apple's trading around 115 right now. Since August 7th is only 2 days from now, that option, and I checked right before we shot this video, was worth about 2 cents. Now, everything in options has to be multiplied by 100. So to buy that option, because it represents 100 shares, to buy that option, you'd actually have to pay $2 plus the commission that you would owe to your broker. So for $2, you have the right to buy Apple shares at 123. Well, the market doesn't think that's worth too much, does it? Because if they're going to give you the right to buy 100 shares of Apple for $2, they must not think that there's much of a chance of Apple getting to 123 in 2 days. And therefore, they're willing to sell that option cheap to you because they don't think they're ever going to have to come through on that option. That would be the person on the other side of the transaction. That would be the option seller. You would be the option buyer. You'd have the right to buy those shares. So therefore, if on Friday, August 7th, Apple is trading at 118, that option that you have will expire worthless. Why would you want to buy option shares for Apple shares for 123 when it's trading at 118? So that option would be worthless. Now, the next question asked by our inquirer is, what is the price of an Apple 110 put expiring August 7th? Now, Apple's been selling off lately. So that one, the 110, 5 points below the market, now that's going to have a little bit more value. So the price of that is in fact 18 cents. The market, and that gets multiplied by 100, and that would be $18. So the market is saying, if you want the right to be able to sell us your Apple shares, and that's what a put is a right to sell shares that you own at a certain price. It effectively puts a floor on the price of your shares. So if you own 100 shares of Apple and someone sells you a put for the 110 strike of Apple on August 7th, that means that if Apple is trading at 110 or lower, you can exercise your put and then buy and then sell those shares. You are putting those shares to the person who sold you that put for 110. So if Apple's trading at a lower price, you are you did well on that put because you were able to put effectively a floor on the price of your shares. So the price of an Apple 110 put today happens to be 18 cents. That means you would have to expend $18 to have the right to take your Apple shares and sell them to someone who has written that option or sold that option to you for 110, no matter how low Apple goes. Apple could go to 25 and you would still get 110 per share from the person who sold you those Apple puts. Now, if you sell an Apple 110 put expiring August 7th, now you're the seller, you're the one, you don't have a right anymore, you have an obligation to buy those shares at 110. The seller of options has an obligation, the buyer of options has a right. So you are now obliged to buy those shares at 110, even if Apple goes down to 25. So the third question is, if I sell an Apple 110 put expiring August 7th, and on August 7th, the price of Apple is 108, how much do I gain or lose? And the answer is this. If Apple is at 108, and you're obligated to buy those shares at 110, then immediately your account is going to be marked down $2 per share. So if you had to buy them at 110, and the shares are running are selling at 108, then are trading at 108, I should say. Then you have a $200 loss in your account. Your Apple shares that you paid 110 for are now only worth 108 immediately. So you take an immediate $200 hit in your account. However, don't forget about that $18 you got initially. You get to keep that $18 forever as a seller of that put. You may regret that you took that $18 in, as you did in this example, but you still get to keep it. So your loss would be $182. $200, which is the hit you took for, the gross hit you took for purchasing those shares, $2 higher than market, but $18 off of that, bringing the $200 down to $182 for the amount of put premium that you received from the buyer of that put originally. So to review the concepts, buying a put, or buying a call gives you a right. In the case of a put, it gives you the right to sell shares you earn at a certain price. It puts a floor on those 100 shares. Buying a call gives you the right to buy shares at a certain price. And so if the stock goes up beyond that price, you have made a good bargain because you're going to be paid most likely, but the stock's actually got to go up higher than the amount you paid for that option. But if it gets to that point, then you're going to do well on that call. The seller of an option has an obligation, in the case of a put, to buy shares at the strike price, or in the case of a call, to sell shares at a certain strike price to someone who has bought the call, who's on the other side of that transaction. So those are just the simple basics of options. And so people can buy and sell options to protect or enhance the portfolios, but they can also trade the options themselves. So if you really think a stock is going to go down, you can buy the put, and if you are right and the stock ends up below the strike price that you bought the put for, plus the amount you paid for that put, you're going to make money on that put. On the other hand, if it never gets to that level, you've just thrown away the put premium, and that's the gamble you take. So some people simply trade the puts and calls, and they don't actually ever exercise and sell their shares or buy their shares, as the case may be. And other times people do actually use the options as a vehicle to dispose of their shares or to purchase shares that they are interested in. So in any event, I know this was basic for some people. For other people, this may open up a whole new world of trading possibilities. And if so, we'd love to chat with you and explain some of our training programs that we have at the Options Tribe. So go to optionstribe.com and join the Options Tribe. You can become a free member. Come to our webinars every Tuesday at 5 p.m. and start to join our community of options traders. And I think you will benefit from that greatly in the long run. So thanks very much, and we'll see you next week.